little bit of soap will wash away your lipstick on my face. But a little bit of soap will never, 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 ever erase the pain in my heart and my eyes as I go through the lonely hills. A little bit of soap will never wash away my tears.
The year 1961 brought some really big hits to the rock and roll universe. The Lion Sleeps Tonight was a major hit. The Summer was ruled by Gary U.S. Bonds in 2:45, and then Bobby Lewis took over with Tossin' and Turnin' All Night. And towards the end of the year, 1961, Benny King left the Drifters. Benny King sang his last hit with the Drifters, I Count the Tears, and then he went right into Stand By Me with Lieber and Stoller. During all that time, the man next to me was recording with a group out of Richmond, Virginia. This is Ray Smith. Ray is one of the Jarmels.
Yes.
The last surviving member of the Jarmels.
That is correct.
And what was the name of your hit in 1961?
A Little Bit of Soap.
Just a little bit.
Just a little
right?
bit.
But it was enough. Burt Burns wrote that hit, and Burt wrote a lot of great songs.
Yes, he did.
What did he do? Twist and Shout.
Twist and Shout.
He wrote Take Another Piece of My Heart, Janis Joplin, Hang on Sloopy.
Yeah.
How did you get connected to Burt Burns?
We went to Laurie Records, and we got there through Benny King.
You just didn't go knock on the door.
No.
Benny King brought you.
Benny King brought us there.
Well, where did you meet Benny King?
In Richmond. He sang at one of the venues in Richmond, and we were on the same show with him.
What was the name of your group then?
Cherokees.
The Cherokees?
Yeah. In that area, right.
You're not part Indian, are you?
No, no.
Okay. But you took the name?
Yes.
All right. So the Cherokees are singing on a show. You're an opening act for Benny King?
Yes.
Or was it Benny? Was it the Drifters at the time? Was he with the Drifters still?
I can't remember. I just remember him, but I think he was by himself.
And you got to know him?
Yes.
He obviously liked your sound. Well, who were the other guys? There were four other members of the Jarmels, but they're all gone. They've all passed away.
Yes.
Who were they?
Tom Eldridge.
Now, what did he sing?
Bass.
Tom sang bass.
Earl Christian, second tenor. Nathaniel Ruff, baritone. Paul Burnett, lead singer. And myself, first tenor and lead.
Did you sing any lead on A Little Bit of Soap?
Not on A Little Bit of Soap. On the backside was The Way You Look Tonight. And I came in with the first tenor part on the middle of the song.
So you traded leads.
Right.
That's what the Penguins did, too, on Earth Angel.
Right.
Yeah, they
traded
leads. Yeah, the Penguins really set the roadmap for a lot of people, a lot of examples for them to follow. How did you get that song? How did Burt Burns get that song to you? Or how did you get to that song? If Benny took you to Laurie Records, they had no black performers at the time.
That's exactly right.
How did it happen?
We performed, sang two songs. They liked it. Then they called us after we got back home and wanted us to come and record. We went back to New York and recorded Little Lonely One. That came out first. That did okay in New York City. And then they called us back to cut another record. And we went back and they gave us A Little Bit of Soap.
What did you think of the song when you first heard it?
Well,
did you like it?
It was different.
Yeah.
It was totally different. But it was an opportunity for us. And what we did, we took the song, went to the subway. We practiced in the subway, and that's how we learned the song. Then we came back and sang it for Jim. Jim and Gene Schwartz sang it for them. They were the owners of Laurie Records. And they liked it. And that's where we met Burt Burns. And we went to RCA Victor Studio.
Where was that at?
New York City.
Where at New York?
It's been so long.
But do you remember walking in?
Yeah.
Now you were just young kids.
Young kids.
How did it feel as these young kids walking in New York recording studio, knowing you're going to record a song? You don't know if it's going to be a hit. You don't know if it's going to be any good. but this is your opportunity. So how do you feel?
On top of the world.
Yes.
And to just see how they put everything together. We recorded the song. We did our part. Then the next thing I know, they had brought in the violins and all the other instruments, and they played their part.
Oh. Now, were you recording with the full orchestra?
No.
You just recorded by yourselves?
Yes.
With somebody playing a piano for
yes.
you?
Yes.
You sang to the piano player?
Piano player and guitar player and drums. Not sure whether a bass player was there or not. But we did on Soap, we might have done 12 takes. Then we did The Way You Look Tonight. That was 23. But that was a little difficult because it was something that, a song that we were not used to singing those type of songs, especially old standards. And this one was a little bit different because someone else had already recorded
oh, yeah.
The Way You Look Tonight. We put it on the back of A Little Bit of Soap.
So A Little Bit of Soap was the A-side?
That was the A-side.
Now, when you walked out of there, you guys went back to Richmond, Virginia.
Mm-hmm.
What'd you think? That's the end of it. You didn't hear it the next day. Did you more or less forget about it until you heard it on the radio?
Not really. We kept thinking about it.
Oh, you kept wondering, when's our record coming
yeah.
out?
And then when it came out, it was just exciting to
now,
see.
Where were you when you first heard it on the radio?
In Richmond.
Where? Sitting in a car? Sitting at home?
No, we were I believe it was Earl Christian's house. And that's when we heard it.
Did you know it was going to be played on the radio that night?
No, I don't think so.
But you happened to turn the radio on and you heard yourself.
Yeah.
How'd you feel?
Great. Great.
That's us. We did it. We've arrived.
Yeah.
And in September, that's when it really got to number 12. It got to be
yes.
a big hit. And after that summer, which was dominated by tossing and turning, finally gave way to... You allow some of the other hits to come up and rise to the top, and that's when A Little Bit of Soap did that. Now, after that, did you do any more recording? Did you ever go back?
Oh, yeah. We went back and recorded probably 12 songs. One of them was Little Bug. Another one was Red Sails in the Sunset, which we hated. All five of us hated it. That was the record right after A Little Bit of Soap. And we hated it.
It didn't seem to fit.
It did not fit.
Yeah.
We never sang it as a group. Never sang it as a group. Then we did, like I said, about 10 or 12. None of them did anything. A year later, they dropped their contract. And that was it.
Do you have any video of you singing A Little Bit of Soap from years ago?
No.
No video? Nothing?
I tried to find the video from Dick Clark Show in 1991. Cannot find it.
You were on American Bandstand?
Yes, 1961. Can't find it. Don't have anything on video of the Jarmels. Nothing.
No, nobody has any amateur video at home, nothing?
Nothing. Okay. And that's the sad part.
I know you got to go change. You got to go?
Yeah.
All right. You're going to be up on stage then in a few seconds
yeah.
here. So, all right. So we're going to be looking for you. Ray, it was a pleasure talking to you.
Same here, Tom.
Okay, buddy.
I wish we had more time.
Oh, yeah. Well, you're a star, okay? And this is what it's like when you're a star. But we'll get together again soon.
Okay.
All right, buddy. Thanks. Bye.
When the world is cold, I will feel the just thinking of you and the way you look.
Thank you. A little bit.